Good day, everybody. It's January 24th today, Edmonton, Alberta. Still not bike riding weather. But I was down washing the bike up, getting the dust off of it. Hate dust to get on it. It's covered, but it still gets dusty underneath the cover in a condo. So I thought I would do a little video, let you see some of the updates that you haven't seen before. And start her up and let you listen to it down here because it is loud down here. So we'll start from the front of the bike. We got the driving lights, and the driving lights have the visors on them. All Kawasaki fire and steel parts, that is, the driving lights and the little visors. And they fit real nice, and I've got a tool bag on the front. So there you go. This bike also, from the previous owner, which it had very low mileage when I bought it last year, it's a 2009 Vulcan Nomad, had these little kind of stars on them. I don't know where he got them. And everybody asks me who's got a Vulcan or something similar because they'd love those. But yeah, they look good. So, hey, like that. The headlight has an HID bulb in it. We'll show you that real quick here once I dig out my keys. The bulb actually moves in the headlight bucket to give you your high and low beam. So, we just gotta start it here. Just let me get it out of gear. There it is. And we start. I can kill it. And if you can watch that headlight, you will see it move. It moves inside the bucket. The driving lights also shut off when you go on a high beam. And on the fire and steel, they have a little switch back of the light right down there to turn them on and off. So that's that. So let's go around here. 3-bag pouch. And I have a tachometer down in there. If you can notice, I never noticed that when you got the off switch on, it turns the light off on the tach. Anyways, it's got a bunch of different colors. It's hit away pretty good. And that's for the driving light. I got a GPS on it, cup holder, or it can be used as a bottle holder, can holder. If you take this off, then it works with a coffee cup real nice. And iPod, which hooks up to my Nolan N43 Trilogy helmet. Now these mounts are all from, hopefully you can see, from Leader Manufacturing. And they are solid billet steel, and they work really nice. They're held on there really good. Now, what's really unusual about these mounts is you come over to this side of the bike, and you see the, we'll try and get you in here, so you can see, if you see down in there, there's the stick that sticks up there. That's for this camera. It mounts on the bike. As long as you've got a camera mount on your camera, a little screw-in mount, it'll work on that mount. And it works really good. You get no wind noise behind the windshield. It works really good. Now that's a double mount, if you can see. It's got the GPS and the camera mount on one. So there you go for that. hopefully you can see that. Up in there, you see that red wire? Well, that's for the HID. It's all tucked in there and it doesn't bother me at all. And GPS changes over. That's an old car I had once. It was my grandfather's car. Best friend from high school. Hey, going through the through everything. I also put a visor on the Speedo. Put on the pegs, front pegs, Kuryakin. It's got a K&N filter and the digital PowerPro processor in it. I've also got a fuse block, an extra fuse block under the seat that works for my lights and anything else I ever want to mount for my iPod, and that it also works. It's got four mini fuses. I kept with the mini because the bike takes some minis. The seat is a Russell Daylong out of Shasta Lake, California, by my understanding. And I got that done. Not cheap. You're looking $1,100 or more. The top is leather, the sides are vinyl. Vinyl on the sides because when you squish vinyl like that, it will react good. If you squish leather down, it will crack eventually just from wear and tear. It's also got a pouch on it. And if you swing the backrest over, right here, if you can see, under here, let's see. See that little silver piece? Well, that's a little triangle, a little wedge. As you move it down, it pushes your seat ahead. As you move it up, it, of course, lets the backrests go backwards. The backrests will also move up and down, and it's removable, very easy. So I got the backrest from them. I got my old backrest redone so it matches the backrest. And that's about it for the Russell Daylong. But it's sure good. You do, it is a little taller and it is a little different from a factory seat. You do have to stand up when you stop the bike because of the way the seat is made with these here supports. So that's the only negative to the seat. Otherwise, you can go 24 hours on that seat, no problem, and never be sore. It's like sitting in a car. Lots of room to move, lots of support, the whole bit. I also put on, these are meant, I believe, for a 1600, 1500 Vulcans. They came with chrome plates. The 1700s came with the blacked out plates, so I put on, bought the chrome ones and put them on. Here we have the tri-ovals, the Cobras. Put those on. I like them. And a Kuryakin license plate, like that. Fire and steel. Luggage rack, and again, I believe that's off of 1500, the emblem. I put that on to just finish off that spot that was kind of bare on the backrest. I also moved my helmet holders, as you see there, from the crash bars up to the luggage rack. Drill one hole on each side. The pin that supports it from turning is in the V shape there, and it works like a dam, and you're not burning your helmet, it's not dragging on the ground, the whole bit. Down here, if you can see that little plug right there in the middle of the lens, that plug is meant for my Nolan N43 Trilogy helmet, which has speakers and it'll pick up FM and it's Bluetooth and the whole bit. It's an amazing helmet, amazing sound. It's convertible from full face to open face helmet. I just love it. I also put on a temperature gauge right there. That's all the states I got it. And it is very accurate. I tested it in boiling water, 212 degrees, and hey, it should work. Now, I don't know the name of the stuff. I got some stuff to put in antifreeze. It's supposed to help lower the temp of the engine by 5 to 10 degrees. You put about an ounce in, and it takes the air bubbles out of the antifreeze that's against the metal portions of your engine, and that way it cools because there is more going through all the time. So I put that in it too. We'll find out this summer if that works. Yeah, I forgot to say I also got these three pouches, and they're useful. This will be the most useful pouch on the back of my backrest to carry my coffee cup, my hat, my gloves, this little camera. If I don't have it mounted, it'll carry so much. I'm really happy I got that. And it's better than digging in your bags all the time. I have the fire and steel liners too for the bags. I don't know what else to tell you about the bike. I should start it. One last walk around and let you hear it and see what you think of the sound. It's going to be loud down here because, hey, that's just how it is. So, if you're ready, we will fire the beast up.
Power Pro really does make a difference. Gave me more power. I believe I get better gas mileage with it. Hey, if you want to know anything about the bike, you can leave me a message, and definitely I'll get back to you and tell you what I know. It will have a trailer behind it one day, a Leisure Light tent trailer out of the Okanagan, for Soyuz actually, Canada they're made. They set up in about 30 seconds or less. So, that's what I can tell you today. Hope you like the tour, and that you enjoyed the video. You all have a great day. Bye-bye.